In this session, we are going to take up questions 16 to 20 of Class 8 Aryabhatta Paper 2017 Section B. So let's look at this question. A number when divided by 195 leaves a remainder of 47. If the same number is divided by 15, then the remainder will be. So let us now take the number to be n. And this we can say is of the form 195x plus 47, because when divided by 195, this is going to leave this remainder 47. Now if we divide n by 15, we can write it as 195x plus 47 by 15, or we can also write it as 195x by 15 plus 47 by 15, or we can say this is 13x plus 3 plus 2 by 15. And now from here we can say that the remainder in this case would be 2. So option B is the answer in this case. Moving on to the next question. If x, y is equal to 6 and x plus x square y plus x y square plus y is equal to 63, then x square plus y square is equal to, so let's first take this equation and then simplify it. We can take out x, y common from the middle two terms, and we can write it as x, y into x plus y is equal to 63. Now we can just move it here and we can say x plus x, y into x plus y is equal to 63. Or we can say 1 plus xy into x plus y is 63. Now we can put the value of xy as 6. So we get 7 into x plus y is equal to 63, which implies x plus y is equal to 9. And now if we take a square of x plus y, this becomes, as we know by the identity, this is equal to x square plus y square plus 2xy. Now let's put the value of x plus y, which is 9, so becomes 9 square is equal to x square plus y square plus 2 into, we put the value of xy as 6 here. So we get 81 minus 12 is equal to x square plus y square. So x square plus y square becomes 69. So option C is the answer here. So moving on to the next question. P is given to be this expression, then P in the simplest form is. So now what we are going to do here is, we will start from the inside and we will move outside and we will keep replacing cube root of x by x raised to power 1 by 3. So this makes it P equal to cube root of x . And now we replace this with x to the power 1 by 3. So this becomes cube root of x raised to power 4 by 3. We'll use the law of exponent here. You can see the video on law of exponents too. Understand this concept here. Now again, we'll replace this cube root with the power 1 by 3. So now this becomes x raised to power 4 by 3 into 1 by 3, or we can say this is 4 by 9. So again, x into x raised to power 4 by 9. So we can say this is x raised to power 1 plus 4 by 9. Cube root of this into x. And then we have another cube root here. So now again, we'll replace this. This we can say 1 plus 4 by 9, we can say is 13 by 9. And we'll again make it cube root of this. So we get x into cube root of x raised to power 13 by 9 is this. So we get cube root of this into x and then again a cube root of this. Right? So now again we make it 1 plus, this becomes 13 by 27, or we can call it 40 by 27, and again we'll take a cube root of this, so we'll take multiply with 1 by 3, so this becomes x raised to power 40 by 81. So let's see if we are taking the correct number of cube roots. We are removing this, we are left with 3 cube roots here and we've replaced it here. Now we have 3 cube roots and we have this x raised to power 4 by 3 in this step. And now again we are removing this cube root. We are removing. We have made this 4 by 9 into x. So we have this cube root and another cube root here. So we have x raised to power 13 by 9 into cube root of that into x and cube. Sorry, this one is extra. This is not there. So now if we see, it becomes x raised to power 13 by x into x raised to power 13 by 27, which we are saying is x raised to power 40 by 27 cube root, which becomes x raised to power 40 by 81. So we can say 81th root of x raised to power 40. So this is the answer, which is option C here. So in these kind of questions, the only trick is that the number of cube roots have to be taken carefully. If we make this kind of a mistake of taking one extra or one less, then we'll get an incorrect answer. So we need to do these kind of questions very carefully. Moving on to the next question. The average age of boys in a class is 10 years. The average age of girls in the class is 8 years. There are 50% more boys than girls in the class. Find the average age of the class in years. Now let the number of girls be x. So then the number of boys will be, they are 50% more than the number of girls, so they'll become 3 by 2x. Now, if we take the total age of girls, because the average age is 8 years, so the total age of all the girls would be 8x. Similarly, total age of boys will be, the average age of boys is 10 years, so 10 multiplied by 3 by 2x, or we can say 15x. So total age of all boys and girls is 8x plus 15x, which is 23x. Right? And the total of girls and boys is x plus 3 by 2x. So we can say 5 by 2x. So the average age of class will be the total age of all the boys and girls, which is 23x, divided by the total number of boys and girls, which is 5 by 2x. So we can say 23 into 2 by 5. So which is 46 by 5, and that is 9.2. So option C is the correct answer to this question. Moving on to the last question of this session. F is a point taken on side AD of a square ABCD. CE is drawn perpendicular to CF, meeting AB extended to point E. If the area of CEF, this would be a triangle here, is 200 centimeter square and the area of square is 256 centimeter square, then the length in centimeter of BE is. So let's first draw this figure. We have this square ABCD. Now F is a point taken on side AD. So we mark any point F over here. Now CE is drawn perpendicular to CF. So let's first join CF and then we draw a line perpendicular to CF. And then that meets AB extended at point E. So this is point E. Now this we know CE area of, so we have to draw this CEF, it becomes a triangle whose area is given to be 200 centimeter square and area of the square is also given. So let us first of all see the triangle CDF and triangle CBE. We know that angle D is equal to angle B, both being 90 degree. We know that CD is equal to CB. They are the sides of square. So they obviously have to be equal. Now we can also see that angle 1 is equal to angle 2 and both of them are equal to what? 90 degree minus this angle, which is, let's name it 3. Right? Because this angle DCB is also 90 degree and we also know that CE is perpendicular to CF. So FCE is also 90 degree. So angle 1 is also equal to angle 2 is equal to 90 minus angle 3. So this makes it CDF is congruent to triangle CBE and this implies that CF is equal to CE. Now if we know the area of triangle CFE is given to be 200 centimeter square and we know the area of this right angle triangle would be half into CF into CE, or we can say half of CF square because CF is equal to CE. So we can say CF square is equal to 200 into 2, which is 400, which implies that CF is equal to 20 centimeters. So we can say CF and CE both are equal and they are 20 centimeters. Now area of square ABCD is given to be 256 centimeter square. So this implies BC, or for that matter any other side of the square, is nothing but square root of 256, which is 16 centimeter. Right, so if we take the triangle BCE, in this triangle, this is also a right angle triangle, we can say that CE square is equal to BC square plus BE square. And we know CE is nothing but 20 centimeter. So 20 square is equal to BC square, which is nothing but 16 square plus BE square. So we get 400 equal to 256 plus BE square. This implies that BE square is equal to 144. BE becomes 12 centimeter. So option C is the answer to this question. Friends, you can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on the new sessions.